Who's Robert Steele? Who isn't Robert Steele? Look, Robert Steele is exactly who I would be if I were like Robert Steele. I've known the guy for almost 40 years, and he has done more for my life than my mom, Buddha, Keanu Reeves.
Jean-Luc, he made me want to get a MacBook Pro.
Elton John, or Prime Minister Stephen Harper.
I know Jean-Luc Delaroche. I knew him when he was The Rock. And he had this thing where he would do Lost Cat posters.
One day I was walking, walking down the sidewalk, and I saw a man cross the street. I walked over to him and I asked him, are you Robert Steele? And he hauled off and punched me in the mouth and said, yes, I am Robert Steele. And I thought that was amazing.
And he would put these posters up just around town. And it was a blank sheet of paper. There was no cat. There was no information where to find the cat, what it looked like, or anything. Then I saw this cat at the corner of my eye, and for some reason I knew it was that cat. And I delivered that cat to that blind 5-year-old, and he seemed pretty happy.
Robert Steele's graphic designs are more important than anything that anybody has ever done in the history of anything. That's all I need to say about it.
Who's Robert Steele again?
Robert Steele?
Well, I think what separates Robert from Jean-Luc is really a certain humility. You know, Robert's got this star quality. He's got the ladies, he's got, you know, the walk, the style, and he knows it. You know, you can just see it when the guy walks around. Jean-Luc is more of a minimalist, you know? You know, diesel ads, Robert. Axe deodorant, Robert. Calvin Klein, Apple, Jean-Luc. You know, the Got Milk campaign? That's all Jean-Luc. You know, Got Milk. Brilliant, that's it. You know, Phoenix American, black and white background, center spaced. You know, who thinks of that? I'll tell you who thinks of that. Jean-Luc thinks of that.
So, what does graphic design mean to you?
Graphic design is all about duality. It's all about the alpha, the omega, the yin, the yang, the serif, sans serif. It's like a spiritual experience, you know? And when the clients, they see the Helvetica on the white background, it just screams to them, buy me, I'm brand new.
The office is all right. I mean, Jean-Luc, he's pretty quiet, he keeps to himself, and Robert, I don't know, Robert can be a bit of a drama queen.
Graphic designers need to understand that their art has to reflect who they are. Look at this, papyrus? Who do they think they are? James Cameron? Well, get that on my face. And this, Is this from the 90s or something? Is there a MySpace link anywhere around here? Oh, fuck. I can't deal with this right now.
Graphic design is about three things. Typography, composition, and hot chicks. You can't do anything these days with hot chicks. You just sell a car, hot chicks. You sell some skinny ties, hot chicks. On the internet, it's all about cats. But in the print media world, it's all about hot chicks. Hot chicks and Century Gothic.
Graphic design, to me, I would say I'm very influenced by the French philosopher Abelard and his theory on ethics, in the sense that an action should be judged by its intention. Therefore, it's okay to break the rules. Okay? Collateral damage is okay in order to achieve the greater good. And in a sense, to me, it's the same with graphic design, you know? There are a set of rules, but in order to achieve a better concept, you should be able to break those rules. You have to think outside of the circle, okay? And it's just like martial arts, you know? Nothing is black, nothing is white. It's all different shades of gray. It's okay to put a little bit of black in the white. It's okay to do a little bit of bad in order to do good. Okay? Those fists are weapons. But the good martial artist uses his strength for the good.
Clients, man. Working with clients is just a series of ridiculous demands followed by more ridiculous demands, and you know, clients want one thing and then they want another thing and then they want another thing, and most clients, they don't even know what they want, you know, but that's why we're here. You know, we're here to guide them, to help them find what they want, you know, what they need, and then we charge him money for it.
So tell me about Robert Steele. I hear you guys have a history.
I've known Robert Steele for a long time, for a very long time. And if you ask me, I would say it's been too much of a long time. We first met when we were in kindergarten and we were 5 years old. And at first things were good. We were friends, we were having fun. But I remember one day our teacher, we had an assignment. We had to draw an animal. And I drew a pink dinosaur and I did a fantastic job. I put a lot of effort, a lot of time into that pink dinosaur. And I remember the day we had to give the assignment, we were sitting next to each other in the bus and I was showing it to him. And I remember that he took it from me. I remember seeing him putting his initials, his name, on the lower right corner of that paper. And he got an A. He got an A plus. He got my A plus. And I've never, ever forgotten that. It was my dinosaur.
So in my artwork, I like to make it visually pleasing for the human eye. I like to make it very stimulating, with lots of colors, lots of content, and lots of hot chicks. It's pretty good. I like to use different types of fonts, styles.
Robert! Hey!
Who are you?
How are you? How's it going? So you remember me? Why did you call me?
Security?
We were together last night. We had this beautiful moment.
Graphic design, it's a process that comes from within, you know? You either have it or you don't. But to me, it comes naturally. And it just comes to me. And when some people would see a blank page, I just see endless possibilities.
A lot of clients come to us as an ad agency and they want an ad with, you know, feelings or vibes or, you know, what the hell do you want from an ad? You know, you want a hard on? Like, no, pop a Viagra. Get it over with.
Some people think that GIP is as good as Photoshop. You know what? I want you to go find those people and bring them to me.
In terms of graphic software, I'm a big fan of GIMP. It's an open source software and it makes
designed free for everybody. I'm a big fan.
So, do you use Skip?
No.
Robert Steele, in terms of style, it's very fractured. Very fractured, and it's all flash and zero substance. And there is no deeper meaning into what he creates. It's like, it's shapes made for the mindless.
You know, how do you make an ad feel wow? You know, what is wow? You know, usually I just get Robert to throw a bunch of pretty colors on it, and that makes him happy.
When it comes to Robert Steele, I have to say that it's a lot of negative energy. The man, the person that he is very dark in the sense that he has no problem taking what other did, you know? He's a thief. He's a thief. He's a parasite, basically. You know? He's just... the universe is ruled by energies, you know? And he just channels the energies that belongs to other people. He stops other people from reaching completion.
You know, we got this new contract and suddenly I've got Jean-Luc and Robert at my neck. They're at each other's necks, they're at everybody's necks. They're like a bunch of rabid, neurotic badgers just like attacking everybody. So, calm down, I said, look, I'll give you guys until tomorrow morning, okay? You're going to come up with mock-ups or concepts, give them to me, I'll give them to the client, and then we'll see what they think. You know, that's it. What else am I supposed to do? You know, maybe I'll just let them kill each other. You know, I haven't seen this much drama since friggin' Adobe changed the toolbar on CS2.
Hey everyone. So it's 2 a.m. in the morning right now. As you can see, I've got nothing done. I can't think of anything right now. Oh man, that sucks. Well, that's the reality of graphic designing for you. It's not all hot chicks and thin ties. Yeah, I hope Jean-Luc has nothing, because right now I can't think of anything. Oh man. So guys, it's 3 a.m. in the morning and nothing's done. It's go time, I guess, now. Desperate times call for some desperate measures.
Finish the project?
Of course I did.
Oh, it was so easy for me. I finished it way in advance. You know what I mean? I went to the auction bar, I went to the tanning bed, worked out, you know what I mean? Just of course you don't.
Just don't talk to me.
Oh, I'm not allowed to talk to you? I'm Robert Steele, but I talk to whoever I want. Mm-hmm.
Really? Go away, please.
What are you gonna do about it? Okay. Hold on. I gotta answer my phone. Is this being rude? I don't really care. Anyways.
Yeah. Hey, Scott.
It's Scott. I got the project.
Yeah. So did I get the project? It's not even winter.